Hello, my dear students. Welcome back to Vasavi virtual program. This is Satish Kumar, Faculty of Chemistry. My dear students, today we are going to discuss about one important topic from chemical reactions lesson. The topic is decomposition reaction. My dear children, I am going to give you first of all the definition for decomposition reaction. Very simple. Those reactions in which one reactant split into two or more products is called a decomposition reaction. My dear children, here decomposition reaction is having another name, that is desynthesis reaction. A very simple example I am taking, my dear students, that is CaCO3, calcium carbonate, that is solid. So I am going to heat the calcium carbonate. So very clearly I am going to get calcium oxide solid and as well as carbon dioxide gas. So from this equation you are understanding, my dear children, calcium carbonate is the one reactant, single reactant. So when I heat that calcium carbonate reactant, that is breaking into two products, that's splitting into two products. One is calcium oxide, second one is carbon dioxide. So here you are understanding that one reactant splitting into two products. So that is why the calcium carbonate heating is a very good example for decomposition reaction or desynthesis reaction. A desynthesis nothing but you are breaking the calcium carbonate by heating. So that is why we are calling breaking of calcium carbonate is desynthesis reaction or decomposition reaction. And one more example also I am taking, my dear students, that is very simple. H2O water I am taking and I am passing electricity into the water. I am giving electricity to the water. So electricity also one type of energy, my dear students. So with the help of electricity I am going to break the water into hydrogen gas and as well as oxygen gas. So here water is the liquid, hydrogen is gas, and as well as oxygen also gas. So you are understanding very clearly here, by passing electricity into the water is splitting into two products. One is hydrogen and another one is oxygen. So the water is the single reactant which we are taking here, and that is splitting into two products. One is hydrogen, second one is oxygen. So this also a very good example for decomposition reaction. And finally, I am going to give you the third example, my dear students, that is silver bromide. I am taking silver bromide. Actually, it is in yellow color. So when I expose this silver bromide to the sunlight, it is going to lost its color and you will get a new color, that is a gray color, my dear students. Because when you expose the silver bromide to the sunlight, it is going to break into silver solid and as well as bromine gas. So here the silver color is a gray color. So very simple, children. When you expose the silver bromide reactant, it is single reactant, one reactant. So when you expose silver bromide to the sunlight, that is going to break into two products. One is silver, another one is a bromine gas. So from this example also you are understanding it is a decomposition reaction. But here the decomposition is happened by sunlight. So that is why this type of reaction is called photolysis or photochemical decomposition, photochemical decomposition. And if you observe the previous slide, my dear students, the water decomposed into hydrogen and oxygen by giving electricity. It means we are giving electrical energy to the water. So the water decomposed into hydrogen and oxygen. So this type of decomposition is called electrolytic decomposition. And the first decomposition is, we have given heat energy to the calcium carbonate. By giving heat energy, we are decomposing the compound, that is calcium carbonate, into calcium oxide and carbon dioxide. Then this is called thermal decomposition. Thermal decomposition, nothing but by giving the heating energy, we are breaking a chemical compound into two products. We are breaking calcium carbonate into two products. That is why it is called thermal decomposition. Here thermal meaning is heating energy. So finally, you got three different examples for decomposition reaction, my dear students. I hope you got it. Thank you.